With the increase of traditional weddings in town, it tells you exactly that something is wrong in the village community setup, and so much of it is being moved into town. The advantage is for those who cannot are not privy to visit the village or to go to the traditional community setups, you know, to be able to leave those experiences and be able to learn, you know, some of those traditional aspects.
Preparations have reached fever height at the Bamenda residence of the Nzelens. A family from So Imbui division of the Northwest region. Their in-laws from Balinyonga in Mezam Division of the Northwest Region will come the next day to seek the hand of their daughter in marriage.
It's a great pleasure to really tell you that the last of us is getting married. It's a blessing. So as you can see, preparations are already going on. We started since yesterday. They have been cleaning up the yard, trying to make sure that there is no dust, watering around, there are young girls around. And today they continue with preparation of the, you can see the goat. These are traditional delicacies that make the color of the traditional wedding. So we also have like chicken, the traditional chicken that is being roasted somewhere to make the kati kati that is going to be part of the menu for tomorrow. The family will invite some elders from the villages to come into the house and they do the traditional rites, and then together we'll come out here to celebrate.
The choice of venue for the ceremony has been influenced by the socio-political context of the moment. The rise of a secessionist movement in Cameroon's English-speaking regions has taken its toll on the country's northwest region, where there are killings, kidnappings, and violent clashes between security forces and armed gangs. And so, traveling to the villages is tantamount to undertaking a dangerous expedition.
Traditionally, this ceremony should be taking place in Banso, in the compound of the bride. But given the current situation in the country, it is not believed that the security situation allows a huge number of people to travel from Bamenda to Banso for the ceremony. So for security reasons, it was decided that the ceremony be moved to Bamenda and maybe a few traditional persons be brought in from Banso and attend the ceremony here. So mainly it's a security concern that brings the event from Banso to Bamenda. For economic reasons, it makes sense to move 10 people from Kumbu to Bamenda than to move 100 people from Bamenda to Kumbu. So in my view, sometimes some people think about that and then choose to move the ceremony to the city, but usually with the permission of the traditional authorities. If the traditional authorities insist, then you would have to take the ceremony all the way to the village.
According to Sok tradition, the bride price will go to the paternal family of the bride in this case.
The first daughter is given out by the family of the wife. That means we have given her back to their family. We have appreciated for the family giving their daughter to us. Now the rest of the girls will be given out by the family of the husband in such tradition, like we are doing today. They did it in Kele, in Siben, and today we are doing it for Bibi.
Traditional marriage in the Banso community warrants that the event begins with a measure of representatives from both families coming into a conclave at the bride's compound. Here, the groom's family presents all the items, characteristics of the event, that had been requested for by the bride's family. Something that cannot be jeopardized, then it is not that bottle of whiskey that will go to the grand uncles of the bride.
In a word, with that, Bibi, Bafoncham.
After praying for God's intervention, the representative of the family head of the bride to be, known as Biki, welcomes their guest and asks them to state the reason for their visit.
Biki, don't talk, say, man, tell Una, say, Una, be very welcome. He say, glad for see Una plenty, and he say, Una strong, he show, say, as Una become that last time, Una go back, go be fine, now why don't Una be able to get energy for come today? Biki ask and say, Una don't go come today, he want for know Una objective for this visit for today. Say, why Una come?
Because I finally said there was no work I come. She would say, even pick the color. I know how they stick there.
Una come, for come at the tree. He talk say, we not go see the tree for color not for inside here because he did so. He be plant on color not now for America. He plant on one now for Holland. He plant on one now for Germany, plant on one now for Kenya. Different countries of the world. Say now na go know. Now na go choose the tree when we don't come out for outside. Say don't see them.
Say now the only one thing we don't survey is say I say not be for among the things we want to get for bread.
Because even if na dry zinc, it be okay.
Not true. You know the zinc shall be cut people in their hands. That zinc that dry one. So, nae for Kariam, these are small, a big.
How
However, he say after we'll see calm down, we'll conclude the talks.
The answer is metaphorical, resulting in a dialogue and subsequent negotiations as the groom's family tries to meet up their target by converting some missing items on the list that was given them into cash, paving the way for both families to arrive at a consensus. This part of the ceremony rounds off with all present drinking part of the palm wine brought in by the in-laws from Balinyonga, while the rest is kept for the second part of the ceremony to take place outside. The second phase of this event takes place at the courtyard, moving from private to the public arena. Negotiations for the would-be bride to be brought out takes place with the groom's family, paying to overcome each obstacle raised by those in charge. The girls that are paraded in front of the groom's family are disguised, and each time they fail to identify theirs, a fine is levied on them. Men and women alike are invited to contribute massively for the bride to be presented. It could be considered a game, but very tricky, as the task in identifying the bride is quite challenging. Thus, only those with keen eyes can pick the chosen one. There is jubilation and satisfaction in the groom's family as your wife has finally been spotted. She is taken back inside to be adorned in traditional costume and is then accompanied by a popular folk women's group in Bamenda known as Vefonsi, to which her mother belongs. There is excitement in the atmosphere. In a move to sustain the spirit of traditional wedding in the Banso land, an envelope referred to as that of the representative of the family head, known as Biki, is being handed, indicating that in-laws from Baninyonga came well prepared.
Actually, there were two envelopes presented. The last one was the envelope of the head of the family, the person called Shu Fai. His envelope had to be presented by the family of the bride to him, signifying the fact that these two families have come together. They are now one. They have united to be one and are going to work together forever and ever.
Traditional proceedings continue with palm wine being opened by the family head, supported by the would-be bride. The family head, after invoking the gods, gives the palm wine to the would-be bride to go pick her husband. The bride is gorgeous in her outfit, dances and showcases her beauty in front of her husband. They both dance happily towards the representative of the family head. The couple now then presents themselves in front of the representative of the family head for marriage rituals to begin.
You bring another week or two?
I bring a Cameroon man. Okay.
Now you are woman, my man.
Yes, now woman. Okay.
Don't please say now you are woman. You are now you are man. No.
I don't agree. Okay.
Now we start now country. We start now country now. No.
Once this is done, the husband drinks all the palm wine as a sign of acceptance. Which, and of course the drink, it's not just chosen by chance.
This is a couple that is coming together for the first time, and they cannot use any other drink because those other drinks are adulterated already. So this one is very pure and is natural.
The palm wine will not be put in the cup for her. She will open it herself. And when she opens it, it indicates that she has accepted to be married to that family.
And that is why in his speech, you heard him say, today that he is giving this palm wine to the woman, that it is given just once, that this cup is never taken twice. As a woman takes it, she gives to the husband, and she can never give to any other man again.
From there, we are going to process to take Bibi now to that family.
Who's that? Come for you. Drink that one. Drink that one. Take up. Drink the
other. The marriage covenant is thus sealed, and the ritual is repeated for the in-laws with the representative insisting on unity and continuity of the marriage.
We not feed bagam. I drink them one time.
The couple is fed traditionally with some healthy slices of egusi pudding, whose role is to ease childbearing.
That was a traditional food by the Nso people, and the food is made up of pounded cocoyam and egusi soup and chicken. When a man takes a wife, the Banso people prepare pounded cocoyam and egusi soup for the wife to give as the first food to the husband. And it symbolizes a lot. It gives fertility to the couple. So it's a kind of blessing to the couple by the family of the woman that prepares the food. The food is going to enrich the family. You can see that it's a very richly composed meal. The woman gives this food to the family for the first time. After feeding the man, the husband, she feeds also the family members of the husband to show how she is going to continue to feed them.
It's amazing because we are getting into another powerful family. Powerful not in the sense of status or so, but because of the cultural background where this daughter is coming from. We are people from Balinyonga, and Balinyonga is one of those tribes in the Northwest that has a strong culture. And marrying a girl from Banso with a powerful culture too, we believe that these two cultures, if they merge together, is going to form a more powerful culture.
The day will be arranged in such tradition to take the wife to the family, to the in-laws. The family will arrange, and when they are going, they will carry things. They will carry baskets of food, they will carry fowl, and many other things. Now, in this family, now we are doing today, if I brought a bag, they will take note of. If I brought a gift, they will take note of it. The family gift, they will take note of it. The head of the family's gift, they will take note of it. When we go now, when we are going now to leave the girl with the husband, the family will be waiting now in their own compound now. When we go, after they have received us, when they go, we'll stand at the yard, outside the yard, singing and waiting. They can come 100 times. We are not satisfied. We will not enter the compound. We will be singing and dancing. We can be there. And sometimes, in the really intro Danish tradition, they take a wife to the husband. It must be early in the morning, 5 o'clock. We start singing outside that compound. The family will know that, they have brought our wife. So they will be coming and begging us now, giving us much more money, giving us much more things now, just to make fun. And it's tradition, that's how they do it. We will be there until when we are satisfied, we will accept now. Then we sing and enter the compound. We can be there for 1 day, 2 days. By the time we are going back, each and every container will have a gift. The bag of corn I brought, they will put something in that bag. The chicken basket with I brought, they will put something, they will tie something now and put it in there, all like that, depending on how many of those gifts were there, to show that they have welcomed us and they have appreciated us. Then there will be another celebration again.
most traditional marriages in the grass field ends with the presentation of gifts, amongst which are pots, which is to assist the just wedded bride to feed her husband, and a baby presented to them as a sign of blessing for them to go expand the family.
Marriage is a gift because not everybody is designed even to marry. And so what we want to thank the two children who have decided to come together and to uplift the family, because they are going to multiply the family. They are going to show that example that they are already showing here to many. And we pray that our children here unmarried will also copy that good example.